Total War Warhammer has just passed 8 years since the very first game released. Today, I have collected all 8 years worth of data and have got it into a spreadsheet to look at averages and unit counts to hopefully predict future DLC or additions to the current factions in the game. I'm sure everyone here has seen lots of videos like these, which are speculation videos based off lore, information from CA, and leaks and those things. This video is not that. I'm only looking at the math of what currently exists in the game to see areas where there could be additions. We'll be looking at averages, total unit numbers, and just overall speculating based off this math. And I'm happy to dive in and share this with all of you. I'm gonna try to explain the spreadsheet real quick so you can kind of understand what I'm talking about as I go through it. On the right side here, we're gonna have Lords, Heroes, Infantry, Missile Infantry, Cavalry, Chariot Cav, Missile Cav, Chariot Missile Cav, Artillery, War Machines, Monsters, Range Monsters, and the numbers beside them are the average number of those types of units in each faction. Obviously, lore friendliness wise, certain factions aren't like dwarves aren't going to have cavalry, obviously. So there's going to be certain things that are going to be skewed because of that. So take that information with a grain of salt as you think about lore. Beneath that, you have below average, far below average, above average, future DLC, and extended roster. The below average numbers you see there, that's the number of below average numbers that faction has, far below average, above average. That's pretty much looking at all factions in general, and that'll make more sense as we go through the video. Without further ado, let's get started with the Beastmen faction. Beastmen are 7 on Lords, 3 on Heroes. Heroes are a little low, Lords are a little low. Missile Infantry is 1. I don't believe that would be lore friendly for them to have multiple Missile Infantry past what they already have, the 1. No War Machines, no Artilleries. That kind of makes sense. They don't have any Ranged Monsters, surprisingly. Total units is 48, and the average is 52, so they are a little low. They do not have an extended roster, though, so in the future, they could possibly get an extended roster where maybe they get some additional units added onto them just to maybe give their faction a little bit of buff. I do not think that they're really going to get DLC in the future. Next, we have the Daemons, which is mostly green in this category. Obviously, they don't have an extended roster, so they could get an extended roster, which could add more units in. And if there's any more DLC for the Chaos factions in general, which is going to be, I could see them getting some additions. So I don't believe there's going to be an actual DLC for this faction. Next, we have Empire. Obviously, Empire just got a DLC, and I think Empire is maxed out now. I don't believe they're going to get any more units. I know people think they will. I just do not believe that, especially based off this math. I think that they're very well set in the average. High Elves. I think High Elves are also not getting any more DLC. They only have 2 below average, far below average, and 2 that are below average. So I don't think they are either. Same way with Lizardmen. I think Lizardmen are also done. There will be no more Lizardmen DLC in the future. I think Lizardmen are set. And that's the first 5 factions. Next we have... Now we're getting into the DLC addition area. The Ogre Kingdoms here has below, far below average on 6, below average on 2, and only 2 that are above average. The chances of them getting a future DLC are extremely, extremely high. Especially when they only have 34 units total. The total average unit count for a faction is 52. With them being that far away from 52, there's an extremely high chance of them getting another DLC. Next up, we have the Tomb Kings, which is a very similar situation to the Ogre Kingdoms. There's 6 far below average here, then you have 1 that's below average, but you combine that with the far below, you have 7 total. You only have 3 that are above average in this category. I absolutely believe that the Tomb Kings will be getting a future DLC. And they do have an extended roster that's not included in their total unit count. But 38 units when the average is 52 is a very far number. Tomb Kings, I think, is getting a DLC. Next up, we have the Vampire Counts, which is C1. And then C2 is going to be the Vampire, you know, Coast. So both the Vampire factions here. I believe there's going to be a DLC. So they're both in a very similar situation on their units. I do think there's going to be a DLC, but I think something weird is going to happen here. I think we're going to get a DLC that's going to have units that goes for both factions, if that makes sense. I think that they're going to have like units that get included through extended roster or maybe additions. It's kind of a weird scenario. Maybe something gets added in between that adds units to both vampire factions here. But I do think the chances are high that one of these vampire factions is for sure going to get DLC, whether that be the original vampire faction or Vampire Coast. Not sure which one, but one of these I think is going to get a DLC. But Bretonnia here, Bretonnia's in a weird spot. Could they get DLC? Yeah, kind of, maybe. But I really think the highest chance of Bretonnia getting additional units is going to be an extended roster add-on. Maybe they just get more human units from the Empire or something like that. There could be a possibility of an extended roster being added onto Bretonnia to give them a little bit higher unit count and to make their faction just a little bit more fun. I don't think Bretonnia is going to get its own DLC or be included in a DLC. Next up, we have the Dark Elves. I don't think the Dark Elves are going to get a DLC at all. Here, there's only four that are below average, and they're not that far below average. Most of theirs is in green, above average. And they do have an extended roster, which isn't included for the unit counts. So I think they're good. They're above average on units. I think they're in a good spot. Dark Elves are done. Next up, we're going to talk about Grand Cathay. Grand Cathay, I believe, is going to get some more future DLC just based off these averages. They still only have 44 units total. They do not have an extended roster either. So I do think that there's going to be a good chance that Grand Cathay gets one more DLC to give it a better unit count and get it closer to the average. Next up, let's talk about Khorne. Khorne here, it's a strong maybe for me. They do have a lot of below averages. I've actually included the new hero unit that just got announced. That pops them up to from 3 to 4. It's strong. I mean, they have 41 units total. They do have some below average. They do have some far below. There's a really strong chance of them getting something more in the future to add on to their faction. Especially when you compare it to a faction like Nurgle. I do believe Khorne's going to get something. It's just a strong maybe right now. Next up, we have Norska. Norska is definitely getting future DLC, especially when you look at this. They have so many that are far below average, and they're very similar to Khorne with that 41. I actually believe that Norska has to get a DLC pretty much. There's no way they don't. They just have too much that's far below average. We're now at the last section here, and we have Skaven. I do not believe Skaven's getting any more DLC. I believe that they're well within the average. I think they're fine. Obviously, there's always a chance, but I just think it's really low with them. Tzeentch, I think, is done as well. I think they're above average on total unit count, and I think they're fine. Chaos Warriors. Obviously, Chaos Warriors are kind of a weird thing. Any type of Chaos, you know, DLC, I believe that they're going to get more units in their extended roster. So I don't think they're going to get a dedicated DLC, but I do think that Chaos Warriors are going to benefit from other Chaos-focused DLCs that maybe they're going to benefit from. Chaos Dwarfs are kind of weird because we just got that faction, but they are technically below average in certain categories. So there could be some add-ons here in the future. I'm not sure really what CA could do in this category. Maybe an extended roster or maybe just units. I mean, they do sometimes give out free stuff. They usually do with heroes and lords or something like that, but maybe we get free units for Chaos Dwarfs. Or maybe in the future, far future, there's an additional DLC. Who knows? Next up, we have the Dwarf faction, which with the newest DLC, I believe they're completely done, maxed out. They're well above the average unit category here. Next, we have Greenskins, and sadly, even though I really like the Greenskins, I believe that the Greenskin DLCs are done. I don't believe there's going to be any more. I believe they're maxed out at this point. Kislev. Believe it or not, Kislev is below average in a lot of categories. Now, they don't have an extended roster, so there's always a chance they could get an extended roster and maybe they get some additional units from other human-based factions. So there's always that chance there. Or maybe they get a DLC. It's hard to tell right now currently where Kislev's going to go in the future, but I think the extended roster option may be a better option than what we currently have with the DLC. Nurgle, obviously, I think it's done. They're above average now, and I think they're in a good spot. I don't believe Nurgle's going to get any more DLC in the future. Slaanesh, very much. I mean, obviously, he's been shown in art. We know Slaanesh is getting a future DLC, and you can see the numbers here of why. They're very much below average, and right now, out of all the Chaos factions, they look the worst in that category, so they're definitely going to be getting DLC. And then we have Wood Elves. I don't believe Wood Elves are going to get any more DLC in the future, and they're done. They do have plenty to me that are above average, and the ones that are below average, I think it's close enough. It's fine. I think that they're also done. 49 compared to 52 on total units is extremely close, and they don't have an extended roster. Actually, no, I'm wrong. They do have an extended roster on the Wood Elves, so, and I'm not including those units, so they're pretty much done. Wood Elves are done. And that's a wrap for DOS Bears spreadsheet. I want to tell everyone thank you for watching this video and checking it out. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And the best part is this spreadsheet, if you want it, I'm going to put it as a downloadable file down below in the description. So you can download this spreadsheet for yourself, make your own spreadsheet, edit this one. You will have this in your hand to examine more closely than what I have here in the video. And it's free for you to do what you want with. So guys, I will catch everyone next time. Have a good one. DOS Bear out.